Here we see the relationship between the binomial series, Pascal's triangle, and in probability, the n choose k process. So this is interesting. Observe that if p is a positive integer, then the binomial series formula can be simplified. So first we start off with this. That's what it was. Then all that we did would go from this step to this step is to rewrite this, distribute in the negative, and get this. Then notice that p factorial, because now p is a positive integer. Did I say that up there? Yeah, positive integer. P is a positive integer. P times p minus 1 times p minus 2 down to this number that you stopped at before in the formula. But if you continued on, this is p minus k plus 1, and the next one down would be p minus k factorial, and that would take you all the way down to 1. So p factorial is this, and then multiplied by the rest of it, which is this. So then you can just divide over. You can write this part right here, which is this part, is p factorial divided over by this. So this, now you get this. Okay? So your coefficients of the binomial series are going to be also able to be written like this. These is the top part. That's just the top part. That's this. Divided by k factorial. Okay, that's the ck. Then you have, that's this right here. Okay, so what that does is you can rewrite that as a single fraction like this, and then put that into your series form for x 1 plus x to the p. You can start at 0 now, because now the way it's written here, it will work. It will give you the proper terms. So this might look familiar to you from before with binomial coefficients. But just to review over that, for p equals 0 in the binomial expansions, Pascal's triangle, which is this 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, which is obtained by, once you get to here, it's 1 plus 1 is 2, and 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 1 is 3, 1 plus 3 is 4, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 1 is 4. And you keep on going like that. So that's how Pascal's triangle is developed, and it matches up with these coefficients. When you algebraically expand out 1 plus x to the first, you get 1 plus 1x. 1, 1. 1 plus x squared, 1 plus 2x plus 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. 1 plus x to the third, if you expand that out algebraically, you'll get 1, 3x, 3x squared, x cubed, 1, 3, 3, 1. 1, 3, 3, 1. If you expand out 1 plus x to the fourth, you're going to get 1 plus 4x plus 6x squared plus 4x to the third plus 1x to the fourth. 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Okay, so how does that relate to our formula up here for the coefficients? When you have, when you're doing the p equals 4 case, which is this case right here, we want to end up with these coefficients being 1, 4, 6, 4, 1 as we run through our k's from 0 to 4. So k equals 0, p factorial over 0 factorial p minus k factorial, that's this, that ends up being 1. And 1 matches up with 1. K equal 1. P factorial over 1 factorial, 4 minus 1 factorial, 4 factorial over 3 factorial, that's 4 times 3 factorial over 3 factorial, that cancels out to 4, and there's your 4. K equal 2, 4 factorial over k factorial, which is 2, p minus k is 4 minus 2 factorial, that's 2 factorial times 2 factorial, that's 2 times 2 is 4, 24 over 4 is 6, there's your 6. And then using the formula continue on, 4 factorial over 3 factorial, 4 minus 3, that's 3 factorial is 6, that's 1, 24 again, that's 4, there's that one. K equal 4, 4 factorial, that's p factorial over k factorial, and p minus k factorial, and that comes out to be 1, which is right here. So these do give you the binomial coefficients. So the CK coefficients of the binomial series give us the coefficients of the powers of x when we expand out 1 plus x to the p. Also, this expression right here, p factorial divided by k factorial, p minus k factorial, parentheses, happens to be the number of ways you can choose k items out of p total items. Not totally a shock, because you either take the item or you don't. It's a binomial situation. Two choices. This is also called p choose k, or in notation, p choose k. The number of ways you can choose k items out of p total items. Here's an example. How many ways can you choose 3 things out of 4 things? So here's your 4 things, A, B, C, D. You can take 3 things this way. You can take A, B, C. You can take A, B, D. You can take A, C, D. And B, C, D. That's the 4 total ways that you can select 3 things out of 4. And let's do that with this notation. P choose K. P factorial over K factorial times P minus K factorial. That's the definition of P choose K. It's also our binomial coefficients for our binomial series. So that's P is 4. K is 3. P choose 4 choose 3. That's P factorial over K factorial. P minus K factorial. That's 4. 4 factorial is 4 times 3 factorial. Just doing that so we can cancel with the 3 and get 4. And there's 4 ways to do it, so it matches up. That's kind of an amazing relationship that all these things have.